Hello, this is Patricia Hazel for Patricia's Potpourri. And as you should know, this episode, all past episodes, and all future episodes may be seen on YouTube. Today is a very special sunny day. Today is a day that I get a chance to celebrate part of my culture. And today we are celebrating Bahamian Independence Day. And today is July 10th, and I wish you would do a little research on how the Bahamas got its independence. The Bahamian American Society has hosted a very special, special event here celebrating our independence at Riverbank Denny Farrell Park in New York, New York. And you may hear the crowd screaming. There's raffles, there's Bahamian food, Bahamian fun, and Bahamian friends. It's absolutely wonderful being here on this sunny day. And at first, it was rainy, and the sun came out for us. There are so many unsung heroes here that was a part of the creation of the Bahamian American Association. And also there was a woman who came along later. You may see her interview her, Miss Audrey Sugar Sparrow, who is an unsung hero. She was a secretary and did so many things despite being limited. And I want to thank looking and listening. It's a wonderful day and a fabulous time to be a Bahamian culture.
Okay, for you who have not been out before, welcome. For you who have been out before, welcome back again. All right. The Bahamian American Association, oh, by the way, my name is Andrew Aldry. I'm president of the Bahamian American Association. And these are the type of events we're trying to get our people back into. So come on out, bring your friends out, Bahamians, Americans, Jamaicans, bring them on out. Let us all party Bahamian style, okay? Now with that being said, we have Ms. McIntosh to lead us in prayer.
Good afternoon. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, this evening as we come before your presence, just to say thank you, Lord God. We thank you for your love and kindness and your tender mercy. We thank you, Lord God, because you are great and greatly to be praised. Say from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, you are worthy. God, we thank you for our Bahamian American Association for 109 years, and we thank you, Lord, for our Bahamian independence for 48 years. And we just give you glory because this is the day that you have made. We can rejoice and be glad in it. Heavenly Father, have your way today, oh God. Have your approval upon each and every one. While we pray for everyone, oh God, that had put this together, that we as a Bahamian American can come together as one, giving you praise and giving you thanks. Now, Lord God, we thank you for life. We thank you, oh God, for fellowship, because we realize and know that there is a great day coming when we all gonna have a great fellowship over on the other side. Father, we bless your name. We thank you for our presidents. We thank you for each and every one. God, we glorify your name. We magnify you. We say thank you, Lord God, for this day. We give you honor. We give you glory. We give you praise because we realize and know through you we move and have our beings. Lord, it being difficulty in 2019 and 2020, but God, you brought us over. And that's why we can say thank you, Lord, for this day that you allow us to come together one more time to lift up your name, and we give you the glory, we give you the honor. We bless the name of the Lord. In Jesus' holy name I pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. As Peter said on the Mount of Transfiguration, it is good for us to be here. We are family, and it's celebration time. Happy Independence to everyone. on this 10th anniversary of the 48th celebration of an independent Bahamas. Allow me to firstly offer congratulations to the Bahamian American Association of New York and surrounding states on the occasion of their 109th anniversary of existence in Harlem, New York. You have kept the dream of those 10 men of Bahamian ancestry who saw the need for an organization to fill the needs for fellowship and community among Bahamian families in the New York area. You have, like St. Paul, fought a good fight, and you have kept the faith. I wish I could say you have finished the race, but there is still work to be done, and we believe you will get it done. To exist that long under trying circumstances calls for perseverance, tenacity, and courage, the key words of your mission. May your mission here in these parts continue, Mr. President and officers, to bloom and to grow. Today, we commemorate and celebrate our independence from Great Britain as we remain a loyal member of the British Commonwealth and of the Caribbean community, CARICOM. Independence Day is a day of reflection, and it is also a day to pay tribute and to express our gratitude for the freedom we still uphold today. It is a day to look forward to tomorrows that are bright with opportunities to be explored and attained. Because of the devastation caused by Major Hurricane Dorian in September 2019 and the COVID-19 pandemic since March 2020, the last 23 months have been quite challenging for all of us. If you recall, it seems like last year, but it was year before last that we were here. We were unable to assemble here this year. Last year, sorry. But this Independence Day meets us faced with continued hope, as is reflected in this year's theme, a celebration of life. Revive us again. Allow me to pause here and extend special thanks to all who rose to the occasion and assisted so willingly during the donation drive on behalf of our brothers and sisters in Abaco and Grand Bahama after that awful Hurricane Dorian of 2019. Please know that your effort was and is greatly appreciated. The past 47 years have brought about many changes. We have seen far too much development to be listed here today. But some of you might remember when in Nassau there was 5-digit dial telephones. On the Family Islands, there was one party line for the entire island. I had experience with a gentleman. My parents owned one of the phones, and the whole community would come there to use the phone. He was trying to get a call through to someone, another settlement, and when he picked up the receiver of the phone, a voice came up on the other line, other end, and the lady said, "I am the nurse. My call is urgent." He said, "Yes, I've been here 3 days. Mine is urgent too." Communication between the islands was by postal service or telegram only. Long-distance calls, as we call them, were only in emergency cases. Entertainment for some was sought from a black and white television set that the neighbors came by to watch, even though the screen looked like a snowstorm was in progress. Many didn't have access to a television and entertained themselves by other means. There is a lot that has changed, some for better and some for bitter, but I will hold off on the others. Because my father told me a long time ago that a good speech is one with a lively beginning and interesting ending, and they are both very near together. So, on behalf of our Bahamian team here in New York, we wish you a day of reflection of our journey over the past 47 years and hope for a year ahead. A year illuminated by grace, dignity, integrity, and resilience. Happy birthday, Bahamas. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce and present to you a young man who fits well into the four adjectives I ended with: grace, dignity, integrity, and resilience. He is a knowledgeable, experienced, and well-accomplished Bahamian diplomat. He is the Bahamas' new ambassador and permanent representative to the United Nations here in New York. Please welcome His Excellency, Mr. Chet Nimoy.
Thank you very much, CG. Obviously, I paid him a lot to make that presentation on my behalf. Firstly, I think you may be getting some remarks that would be circulated that would have come in from the Governor General, who sends his personal congratulations to the association as well. I spoke with him the other day, and he said to make sure that everybody knows that the Bahamas is on the rebound. The Prime Minister also sends his regards, and you'll be getting an update from him as well. And our Foreign Minister, who has, I send out special prayers to him quite often because he has been dealing with the recovery from Hurricane Dorian in his constituency. And he's also been leading the charge with the international agencies in ensuring that we're not, that we don't succumb to the inability of being able to access the COVAX facility to get the injections for COVID recovery. I want to start out by thanking, and I start out without proper protocol by intention, because I think the association, the Bahamian American Association Incorporated.
Yes.
And I say the word incorporated is usually associated, you normally hear that for fraternities, incorporated, or sororities, incorporated.
Right.
And I want to thank you very much for all of the arrangements. And I also want to pay homage to Mr. William Dames. Mr. Dames, he's more moved on to glory, and we'd also like to give recognition to him for his role that he played in the association as well. 109 years, that's at least X number older than I could ever be. And it is an achievement. I also would like to thank Consul General Larry Cartwright, Mrs. Cartwright, who've known me for longer than 109 years, who's known me for quite some time. I'd also like to thank his staff. And I'd like to also thank in public presence, Ambassador Missouri Sherman. And I'm the 10th ambassador to serve in the United Nations permanent mission. I actually should be the 11th because Ambassador Missouri Sherman set up the office in during the independence in 1973. And I think she had done that in connection with another nation who we are most grateful for. But you know, you always say you have to give thanks and honor to those who came before us, and I do so very publicly. Ambassador Missouri Sherman, who also serves as the permanent observer to CARICOM here in the United Nations. I'd like to thank the staff of the permanent mission of the United Nations. I see my head of chancery here, and I see some of the other members. I thank you all for embracing me and welcoming me into what is now my new home here in New York. I look forward to doing greater things. I want to thank the other two members who had whose tour of duty came to an end, and they are now at home. But we can send the word out to Mishana Russell and Angelica Hillebrand, who was a part of the team, and they're now serving at home. The past few years have been challenging, to say the least. The unprecedented devastation of Dorian was more than enough for us to deal with for a lifetime. But the pandemic, of course, came along and compounded the burdens that our country and those around the world faced. Sometimes, over the past 2 years, when grappling with the enormity of the challenges that we faced, I found myself recalling 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8 through 9. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed. Yes. Perplexed, but not despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. Struck down, but not destroyed. We, however, have proven time and time again that we, Bahamians, are resilient people. And now, in line with our independence theme this year, I have found comfort in the exhortations in Psalms 85, asking God to revive us again. A part of my task is also to bring updates, because I've been asked on numerous occasions what's happening in the Bahamas. I'm pleased to affirm that we are indeed in the midst of a revival back home. Recovery from Dorian in Grand Bahama and Abaco has been steady, and we are committed to building back better. While the pandemic restrictions have certainly proved to be inconvenient, they have helped us. They've helped us as we are confident and we are able to put COVID-19 in our rearview mirror. We've been able to access the vaccinations, and we are looking, and we've been able to reduce hospitalizations and deaths. Tourism is continuing to surge back with new opportunities around home porting as a cruise ship destination. We anticipate a dynamic season in the fall and winter coming up as we continue to catch up to the progress with managing COVID-19. The government's commitment to help supercharge our recovery has been reflected in the Accelerate Bahamas budget that was just passed on July 1st. Hundreds of millions of dollars over the year will be injected into the economy, and investments in the Bahamas and investment in Bahamian people and Bahamian businesses will allow us to weather the current storm, and will also allow us to come out on the other side even stronger than before. On the matter of diaspora engagement, which falls under the purview of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, while sun, sand, and sea are what most know the Bahamas for, the greatest asset that we have is our people, you, persons like yourselves and friends of the Bahamas who live outside of the United States, who lives outside of our borders. Furthermore, given the small size of our population, we are not only talking about those at home, but we're talking about those who span the globe. We see you in the diaspora as critical partners in the revival and vision for our country. And we are looking to redouble our efforts to leverage the skills, the knowledge, the connections, and other resources that you may wish to invest in the Bahamas. We know that engagement is a two-way street, and we are, however, committed to joining hands as we go forward. While I was barely old enough to really absorb the significance of the time, the moment we lowered the Union Jack at 11:59 on July 9th, 1973, and raised the aquamarine gold and black, was both the culmination of a crusade for revival towards a more just and equitable Bahamas, and the start of a journey of the renewal, rebirth, and revival of our country. It has been a journey filled with many highs and some lows, but in totality, it has been 48 years we as Bahamians can be immensely proud of. While we celebrate our independence this weekend, we must remember that for any nation to continue to prosper, there must be intentionally a collaboration, the wind is not collaborating with me, among all stakeholders involved. In a country as small as the Bahamas, we cannot afford for any of us to be spectators. That spirit of revival that drove our forefathers to push for and entertain and attain independence is most important. And I say happy birthday, happy 48th, and I wish you all a wonderful Independence Day. Thank you. And I want to particularly thank Ms. Roll. I think Ms. Roll went out and secured these premises well in advance. And she and I had a discussion when I came in. Because if you have to wait on government sometimes, you know the rest. So Ms. Roll, thank you very, very much for the work that you continue to do here along with the association.
So I just want to say thank you again and welcome to everybody. In recognition of the 48th anniversary of independence of the Bahamas, as well as the 109th anniversary of the Bahamian American Association, I say thank you for being here. As we stand here, and I know we've all introduced ourselves, and I just want to point out a few of our members that are here as well. So this gentleman to my right in the Vietnam vet hat, Mr. Creswell Muddings, one of our senior members. He's been in the association, I would say, over 50 years. We have a former board member, Mr. Keith Stubbs. He's also been around quite a while. And we welcome new members. So, as you know, we have a brownstone on 211 West 137th Street. And so I would ask that you all stay tuned for upcoming events. We do have membership forms here as well. Speak to any of us, Andrew Aubrey, our president, Mary Sweeting, our chair of the board. Also, I'd like to say a special happy birthday to everyone who has a birthday this month. Andrew celebrated a birthday as well as Mr. Sweeting. I'm sure there are other people here as well. Ms. McIntosh that gave us that moving prayer. Cecile Freight as well. So happy birthday to everyone. So I'm going to just turn the mic over to our chair of the board, Mrs. Sweeting. I am hopeful that when we go back, we can partake in a nice, delicious meal.
Yes. To God be the glory. On this day, as we celebrate, I ask that each one of you take a moment and meditate on how good God is. Just reflect back as to where you were a year ago today. On behalf of the Bahamian American Association, which you know we will be celebrating 109 years of existence, and we are in the village of Harlem, located at 211 West 137th Street. That is historic. It is very, very historic. And I want you to know that we invite you to come by and assist, to share in the celebration of those of the ancestors from the Bahamas who thought that it was not robbery to come and live in the United States and choose a historic area such as Stryver's Row in Bahamas, from the Bahamas to New York City. I also would like to give recognition to all of the persons that have gone before us that's no longer with us. We have had some trying times. I'd also like, by a show of hands, to see those that are now members of the Bahamian American Association. Just raise your hand. Don't be shy, because those of you that didn't raise your hand, I will be coming by and asking you to join the association. We can no longer continue to sit back and let others do for us what we need to have done and we can do for ourselves. Having said that, I'd like to also acknowledge some of the people that are present, and forgive me if I do not call your name. I'd like to acknowledge that we do have a member, a current member on our board, and that member is none other than Calvin Martin. He is the former Grand Marshal, Master, Grand Master for the Masonic Lodge. He is very dedicated to us, and he will be doing and continue to do. I'd also like to acknowledge representation from one of the largest housing Mitchell-Lama developments. We have a member for the board, and that's none other than Hattie Thomas. Another member, Nadira El-Amin. Another member, Gail Earle. These people are the ones that help us to maintain the association. They are not Bahamian, they are Americans. But because of the root and fruit of the love that we give, we continue. In the absence of Judge Thompson, and Judge Michelle Sweeting, who are members of the Bahamian American Association and are practicing judges, sitting judges here in New York. I bring you greetings from them. And I say to you, let's live, love, and be happy. So everybody, shout it out. To God be the glory.
So just before we disperse, we're just gonna have a moment of silence as well as we're gonna raise the flag. Ms. Vernell Thomas Witherspoon will sing for us the national anthem.
Should I turn this way? Yeah, should we all turn towards the flag, please?
Should he raise it?
Yeah.
Lift up your heads to the rising sun, Bahama land. March on to glory, your bright banners waving high. See how the world marched a manner of your bearing, pledge to excel through love and unity, pressing onward, march together to a common love to go, steady sunward, though the weather has a wild and treacherous shore. Lift up your heads to the rising sun, Bahama land, till the road you trod leads unto your God. March on, Bahama land.
Hi everyone, I'm Jonathan Lockhart. I work with the Bahamas Ministry of Tourism. I just moved to New York on Saturday to move as a sales and marketing coordinator in our tourist office in New York. And I'm just here to let you know that tourism is booming. We're in recovery mode, but we're open and looking for everyone to come down. We have two websites that I would encourage you to look into to get all updates on tourism in the Bahamas. It's tourismtoday.com and bahamas.com. But we're welcoming everyone, and come down and spend a night with us. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Brenda Bain. I'm here today celebrating the celebration of Bahamas Independence. And I'm a lifelong member of the Bahamas Association, so it's a pleasure to be out here to enjoy the good weather and to fellowship with some of my Bahamians. Of course, you know that I'm a Bahamian, and I've been in New York for practically all my adult life. So today I'm enjoying the Bahama Day, and I just hope everything goes well, the weather is fine, and we have a good fellowship today. Thank you very much.
My name is Creswell J. Munnings. I'm a longtime member of the Bahamian American Association. And we are proud of the association because it's a place where we can come together with friends of the Bahamas and Bahamians and enjoy ourselves. I occupied the office of Vice President and Chairman of the Board and also Treasurer of the organization. I've been in the organization since I came to New York in 1957. Wow, I'm always here doing whatever I can to improve the situation, to help our people that are in distress, and to got a few more little them to the United States, teach them the way to go. And I'm proud of this day because we came from under the tyranny of Great Britain and become an independent nation. And that is telling. That is telling. And I'm proud for that. Thank you.
I am Maria McDonald, originally from Managua, Bahamas, and I am very grateful to see 48 years of our independence, and I'm happy to say that I rejoice in it, and I'm hoping that we will go forward in grace and in mercy.
Amen.
Amen.
My name is Coraline Johnson Claire. I work for the Bahamas Mission to the United Nations, and I'm celebrating the Bahamas Independence with my co-workers, my family, my friends. I do this every year, and I'm just here to enjoy the Bahamian food and the festivities and mingle with other Bahamians living in New York, New Jersey, Connecticut. We all here to have some fun and reminisce about the Bahamas and enjoy our independence. Peace.
Boom.
Very good.
My name is Roxanne, and I'm here at the Bahamian Society's Independence Day celebration. I'm a teacher. I'm out here celebrating community and culture. Everything that we've been through this past year, it's nice to be out and about and see people smiling and laughing and just socializing and coming together.
Hi, I'm Poan. I'm a OBGYN. I'm so happy to be here at the Bahamian Association. It's an amazing time. I feel so welcomed here even though I'm not Bahamian, but I feel like I'm family. It's been a great day.
My name is Miss Sugar Audrey Farrell, and I am semi-American and a friend of the Bahamian American Association. I've been with the Bahamian American Association for many, many years, and I'm so happy to be here today because it's been a few years since we have been able to have a family fun day and to see so many turn out at such a short notice is a wonderful thing. I've watched the Bahamian American Association come out of a very hardship of financial status and now rising up again. I came to the Bahamian American Association through the late Daisy Strawn. She's a very strong president, and she got us rolling. She taught us how to do everything that we know today. And Mr. Dames, who took her place, the late Mr. Dames, because he too has passed, he carried the ball after her, and hopefully Mr. A.A. Aubrey will continue to keep the association going. This is a difficult task that has been presented for these people, but if they just stay together and pull hard, they can succeed in every goal that they have set before themselves. We would like to see more young people come out and participate with their children to teach them to do family affairs.
Hi, my name is Dr. Renee. I'm currently at the Bahamian Society's Independence Day. We're enjoying a great time out here in the park with family, friends, great food, great entertainment. And we're looking forward to doing this again next year. Thank you.
Are you okay, Marie?
Yes, I'm okay.
Yeah. How are you enjoying yourself?
It was good. I have a good time.
Tell me, what was your favorite part?
The food.
The food?
And seeing people.
Yeah. Have you ever eaten this food before?
Not all of it, but the rice and peas was good.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I love it.
You like the spices?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm a spicy girl.
Oh.
Okay. Where are you from, Marie?
From Gambia, West Africa.
Yeah, how'd you get here?
My uncle was the ambassador of the UN, Gambia.
Oh. Okay, how'd you get into this park?
I came with Miss Sugar. Miss Sugar invites me.
We at the Bahamian Festival. We are having a great time.
It's fine. We're shaking the vibe.
Shake it up, shake it up.
What's the number?
642.
Take your ticket.
I am Sharon Moss, and I am representing the Bahamas, our beautiful country. And yeah. Bahama girl, okay? Independence Day.
That song, that is all, that is all.
Stands for the sun. The turquoise stands for the beautiful waters of the Bahamas. And the black stands for the black skin of those of the Bahamas. I want to thank everyone in the Bahamian community and who has come out today, whether they're Bahamian or a friend of Bahamian, Bahamas. I want to thank you so much. And I want you to participate and come to future events. But one of the best things is to visit the Bahamas. I'm telling you, there's nothing like it. It's always better in the Bahamas. Thank you. Please tune in to future episodes of Patricia's Pokery. And I want to thank all those who I interviewed. Thank you so much.
Hello. Today we're in the, at the park. Well, not at the park, but we're celebrating Independence, 4th of July. We have, there's a party too, but I guess it's end, but I'm gonna show you some stuff.